Hello, my name is Wen Ping. In bug bounty, people always talk about running recon, automate your workflow, and etc. But how do you really do it? Well, there are many ways, and one of the most common methods is to create a VPS, which is a virtual private server to run your automation. So today, I'm going to show you the steps to creating a VPS on DigitalOcean. After logging in to DigitalOcean, you can create a project. For my case, I have named it as Project Hope. Next, you can select Spin up a droplet. In the terminologies of DigitalOcean, a droplet is a VPS. Now, you can start configuring your droplet by selecting its region, data center, and other information. Over here, you can see the current pricing of your droplet. It is very transparent. By the way, if you want a free $200 credits to try out the DigitalOcean features, you can find my referral code in the description below. Over here, I have selected Singapore as the region of my droplet. And these are the data center and VPC network selected by default. Next, choose an image to install on the VPS. There are many options under the OS section, and you can also browse to the marketplace. For example, if you click on this Docker image, you can read about its information, such as its description and also the detailed steps to deploying it on your VPS. Now, return to OS and choose Debian version 12. For the size of droplet, this is very important because it will directly impact the cost of running your droplet every month. It's pretty straightforward because the more resources you use, the more it will cost. As you can see, the cost of running your droplet can go as low as $4 per month. In this setup guide, I will choose the mid-tier plan, which will cost $24 per month. You can even add a volume if you require additional storage. Choosing an authentication method is pretty important too. If you use SSH key pair method, you can directly log in to your droplet without the need to key in any password. However, you can also choose to use password to log in. Just make sure that you set a strong password. In this setup guide, I will be using SSH key pair method to log in. These are additional services provided, either for free or chargeable. You can customize them based on your needs. Finally, you can name your droplet and add some text for search purposes. Click on Create Droplet once you are done. It will just take a while for it to be created. Alright, it's done. You can now copy the IP address of your droplet. Log in to your droplet using SSH. Since you are using SSH key pair for login method, you have to choose yes for the first login attempt. And there you go, you are logged in as root now. With this, I have come to the end of my setup guide for how to create a VPS on DigitalOcean. I hope it is useful to you and can help you get started with the creation of your own recon, automation, and workflow machine. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you have any experiences with setting up a VPS, or with DigitalOcean's droplet, please share them in the comments. See you in the next video.